All right, what's going on today, guys? So thank you for joining me on today's video. Another objection handling question that a lot of SMA owners get: what kind of results will I see? So in one of the videos I talk about, do you guarantee results? This is another way that clients will frame the question: what kind of results will I see? And this is where you got to be really, really careful on like the claims that you make on your, you know, discovery call, whatever you're doing. There's a couple ways that I really frame this to be massively congruent and also answer their objection very, very well. So make sure you like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate all you guys watching. So client says, what kind of results will I see? They're usually asking this to get a number out of you. They want to hear some numerical number of like X amount. So what I usually say is like, well, you know, that is a very variable question. It's based on, know, your creatives, cost per click, you know, click-through rates, conversion rate, and then your, you know, upsells, your AOV. There's so many factors that will predicate these results. So what I will say is that, you know, once we're able to see data and traffic coming in, then we can make a better assumption. But you need to prove, and this is mostly people who like are like starting and they don't have a ton of data. Okay, there's one answer that you can get. They're like, well, that's a very variable question. It's based on your creatives, cost per click, all these different variations. There's so many factors that will predicate these results. So what I will say is that we're able to see data. And once we're able to see data and traffic coming in, then we can make a better assumption, but you need to prove your concept first. You know, that's what we're here to do. Get you conversions, leads, but you need to get, you know, all these assets done first. Okay. And then you can add on, like, another variation is like, you know, can I be honest with you? And they'll say, you know, yes or no, whatever. They're obviously going to say yes. Can I be honest with you? My honest, serious, like, people to people level. They're going to say yes. And you're going to say, I'd love to give you an XYZ expectation that will make you smile and run around your house excited. But personally, I won't. Here's why. If I set a false expectation with you, that means I've had to have done that all my clients. And since we don't have a 100% success rate, I wouldn't be in the position I am. Reputation that I have, since I have shown you a decent amount of results today, especially ones in your niche. Recent. That being said, I will not tarnish my reputation. For you to swipe your card today. Right? Because if things, you know, aren't like the results that I've shown you, then you're going to be pissed. You're going to tell people how bad your experiences were when I've been in this niche for 4 years and I've never had anybody do that, because I'm very transparent. I'm very upfront. So that's why this angle, I can't be honest with you. I'd love to give you an XYZ expectation that will make you smile and run around your house excited, but personally, I won't. Here's why. If I set false expectations, that means I've had to have done that with all my clients to get the sale. And since we don't have 100% success rate, I wouldn't be in the position I am with the reputation that I have, since I've shown you a decent amount of results, especially ones in your niche of recent. I wouldn't be in the position I am with the reputation that I have since I have shown you a decent amount of results, especially ones in your niche of recent. With that being said, I will not tarnish my reputation just for you to swipe your card today. I want this to be a growth. No, I want this to be not just the best decision, you know, you make today. You make all day, but I want this to be the right one. With someone who's honest, has, you know, integrity, know his place, and is willing to work hand and fist to give you what you need. The other angle I use is like, I mean, the second one's the most of the time the one that I use, right? So then I say, after two, right? Then I'll say, and this is the follow-up to two. And this is like the main one that I use. Follow-up, you know, they'll say, you know, I understand. I'm like, you know, would you rather have me lie to you? Just to get you to pay and set an unrealistic expectation that will make you angry and lose sleep if we're a couple thousand dollars short on our expectation, or would you rather have someone who is honest, has results, has proven tactics, that you've seen today, and you can trust moving forward? That's the better angle, because then you can use the angle of like, listen, like if I don't get you X amount of sales the first week and we have this 3-month commitment together, you are now going to have this trust resistance for the next 2.5 months and you're not going to want to trust me anymore. Do you want that to happen? Do you want to have this fulfillment go down the drain? Now you have to get up and move, go to another ad agency, try to find the right guarantee that you want because you've already had a false expectation given before. That's the way I answer this question. So hope this video brings you value. If it does, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video.